Carl. Each year, the graduates select one of their own to reflect the character of the class. This year's speaker is an honors student, particularly noted for the humanities and social sciences. A devoted community servant, both locally and in Nicaragua, and a leader through youth and government, and on campus as senior class president. As a classmate notes, she shines wherever she goes. Please welcome Olivia Harvey.
Combination of words, I was surprised to find a saying of Winnie the Pooh ringing the most true. This wise bear states, "How lucky am I to have something that makes saying goodbye so hard." Although this graduation is a different type of goodbye, marking more of a celebration of accomplishments and a push into a new world, it is still a goodbye. A goodbye to high school, to our classmates, to the passionate teachers that have cared for us for the last 4 years. It's a temporary goodbye to the parents that have cared for us for the last 18. And put simply, it's a goodbye to adolescence. Many of us may be more excited to say hello to what lies ahead than we are sad to say goodbye, but the magnitude of this ceremony, the senior trip, and the change we are all about to face are just testaments to how great this goodbye is. Now, as I dissected Pooh Bear's saying, "How lucky am I to have something that makes saying goodbye so hard," I figured, since this is pretty hard, I must be pretty lucky. How lucky am I to have parents that work so hard and sacrifice so much for us to get this education, who push themselves to give us better opportunities than they were afforded, and may now slightly regret that as they watch us move across the country. How lucky am I to have teachers who are experts in their fields and will stop at no ends to help us succeed, who assign countless group projects and essays and labs that we may grumble through in the moment, but ultimately come out more prepared for higher education than the majority of this country. Teachers like Mrs. Fox, Mr. Ishii, Mr. Kleinsaucer, and Dr. Wahi, who dedicate hours of tutoring to just one student, and Mr. Myers and Senora Canton, who meticulously plan around stressful times like JPD or college apps. How lucky are we to have teachers whose passion for teaching gets students so excited to learn that they spend hours more than required to prepare their mock trial arguments, who stay after every single class to ask a random question or share an article with their favorite teacher. Students motivated to read that new book their teacher was raving about, or start a club because 43 minutes of math or science just wasn't enough, and now they want to compete in it. How lucky am I to have friends and classmates that make saying goodbye so hard? To be part of a unique assortment of individuals and arguably the best senior class in a long time. For the past 2 years, I personally have been both honored and challenged to represent this group as class president. Honored because I could not imagine a more welcoming and kind group of individuals. Every person on this stage is extremely multifaceted and passionate about their own interests. And what makes our grade so unique is the ability for us to recognize that in each other. We are in awe of Olivia Wong and Brendan Ashworth's achievement in marathons. We admire Cole Slater's strong sense of fashion, Ari Bratkus's random decision to make mead, and Brandon Gunning's impeccable baking. These seniors can easily find friendships outside of their friend group through a shared free period or difficult class. I truly believe that any classmate sitting on the senior patio can be your best friend for the next 43 minutes. And we have embraced that approachability, even down to the senior trip, as we all confessed our admiration for those we hardly knew and those we wish we knew better. The spirit of community at Prep is in no shortage in the class of 2018 and every single one of us sitting on this stage. Yet no matter how proud I have been able to say that I represent the class of 2018, it has been a challenge nonetheless. A class of born leaders is pretty difficult to put into a box. We are constantly growing and pushing each other to grow. Now you may not know this, but I am one of the youngest people in this grade. I've always refused to imagine myself in the grade below because I would be a completely different person without those who I'm surrounded with. As I've tried to lead my classmates, some even a full year older than me, I've constantly been pushed to be better. I realized that this was a trend for our entire class. Everyone pushes each other out of their comfort zone. Yet this doesn't stem from a spirit of competition, but simply from being in such an inspiring environment. We tutor each other, challenge each other's beliefs, debate, share Quizlets, and worship Tiana's study guides. So, as a young leader, I've been stuck between constantly looking up to my classmates and simultaneously feeling so proud to be part of this group. I finally decided I could feel both ways. I've learned what it is to admire and to boast, to be both honored and humbled to sit on the stage surrounded by those who I'm sitting with. So how lucky am I to be sad to say goodbye? Although it may sound ridiculous, I truly believe these words. I've been told by every media source, my own parents, and many friends outside of Prep that high school is simply, unavoidably, the worst 4 years of your life. Yet at the pinecone ceremony this past week, I heard countless people say, and I quote, thank the group for the best 4 years of their life. Well, high school, as advertised, can be a miserable trudge through test taking and awkward social situations, Prep has opened it up to be one of community. Walking around campus, you notice a community everywhere you look. A community within clubs like Pie and Prejudice, those who love pie and also books or just gossiping. A community of Naruto fanatics. A community of people whose names are a mystery to Harry Burke. A community of teammates, classmates, performers, and friends. So, as we prepare to leave Prep, I find myself not necessarily scared for what the future holds, but unsure of what I will do without the community of peers, teachers, friends that I have grown to love. So how lucky are we to have something that makes saying goodbye so hard? Thank you.
Recognize several of the groups.